everyone, my name is Iris Franz, and today we're going to continue to talk about market equilibrium. So in the last video, we talked about market equilibrium, and equilibrium price is the price where your quantity demand is equal to quantity supplied. So there is no excess demand, there is no excess supply. So what happens when the price deviates from your equilibrium price? If the price is too high, then we have an excess supply, or we call that surplus. And if the price is too low, lower than equilibrium price, then we have a shortage or excess demand, meaning your quantity demanded is higher than quantity supplied. And the story doesn't just end there. If the price deviates from equilibrium price, then the market will typically adjust itself. I say typically because it's not always the case. So think about an example of surplus or excess supply. Sometimes you go to a Kroger to buy milk. Kroger is a supermarket. And typically a gallon of milk costs about $3. And you saw a gallon of milk there, and you say, special, on sale, $1. And you wonder, why is it on sale, $1? And then you take a closer look, you realize that milk is going to expire tomorrow. So you see, when the milk is about to expire tomorrow, at price $3, there is an excess supply, meaning you have milk there, but consumers don't want to spend $3 to buy a gallon of milk that's going to expire tomorrow. And therefore, Kroger will have to lower the price, and when the price is lower, that will increase quantity demanded and reduce quantity supplied. So adjustment will continue. So if the price is higher than equilibrium price, then the seller will try to cut the price, lowering quantity supplied, increasing quantity demanded until the price reaches equilibrium price. Then the market is cleared. And we just talk about Kroger, that's an example. They lower the price of milk that's about to expire to increase the quantity demanded. And example of quantity supply or excess supply is that, think about you go to dinner on Saturday night or Friday night. Usually that's a prime night. A lot of people are going out to have dinner. So if you go to, say, Outback Steakhouse, you typically have to wait for your table. And when you're waiting for table, say, half an hour, that means there's a shortage. And why is that when there's a shortage? We know that the sellers usually will try to increase the price, right? We say the market will adjust itself. Well, this time you don't see the sellers trying to increase the price. You don't see Outback Steakhouse trying to increase the price for dinner on Saturday night. Why not? Because they're afraid of pissing off their customers. Their customers will think that, hey, you guys are price gouging, right? So even though you have to wait for your table, there's a shortage of tables on Saturday night and Friday night for dinner. Sellers, they feel hesitant about increasing their price because they're afraid of pissing off their customers. So you see, sometimes adjustment doesn't occur. And this concludes our market equilibrium. And good luck with your studying. I'll see you next time.